I wish I didn't have any holes. If I didn't have to worry about things going in and out of my holes, life would be so much easier. Sure, I'd have to give up talking, and I like talking, but I'd also get to give up public restrooms. I mean, there's always something on the sink, but it's just like, why? Historically, I will choose the handicap stall, which is my personal favorite because it's usually the cleanest and it has the most legroom. But lately, I've been experiencing increased anxiety that some kid in a wheelchair will be waiting outside the stall when I exit, and he's going to glare at me once he sees that I'm clearly physically unafflicted. The more times you use the handicap stall, the likelier it is to happen. It's like a car crash. It's not a matter of if, it's just a matter of when. But then if I don't drive a car, how will I get anywhere when the bus is unreliable and filled with homeless people or social delinquents who resemble homeless people? I suppose if you were truly homeless, you wouldn't take the bus either because you couldn't afford it or you have nowhere to go, one or the other.
Todd, I think we're getting a bit off topic.
Well, it's my job to be tangential. It's your job to magically relate everything to my problems.
Okay. You treat sex like the kid in the wheelchair. Mm. The handicap stall is a metaphor for your state of sexual confusion. Mm. And you're afraid of the kid because he might tell you that you're in a wheelchair too.
But I'm not in a wheelchair.
You're in an emotional wheelchair.
So does that mean I'm not gay?
I don't know. It's just a metaphor.
I think I might not be gay.
You're gay.
You don't know that.
Todd, your favorite film is Legally Blonde.
Well, that's just it. I've always dismissed the possibility of having any heterosexual feelings, but I think that's because I've been socially conditioned to be gay, gay, gay. Kids have been calling me a faggot at recess ever since the second grade. I never really had the opportunity to explore the female gender.
So you want to start dating girls?
I think it would statistically improve my love life.
Don't take this the wrong way, but even if you wanted to experiment, I don't think you'd find anyone. Girls aren't gay blind anymore. This isn't the 60s.
And you're no Rock Hudson.
I don't think that I'm that transparent. I could just be metro or a hipster.
Todd, you're like a Kinsey 6, maybe a 5 when you're not wearing cashmere.
Well, I think that I could get it down to a 3. Frances says that my masculinity has been suppressed by my own precognitions of sexual identity, and she thinks that I could be happier if I'm more aggressive and I don't let political labels like gay define me.
Sorry, political labels?
Yes, we choose to be gay.
Can I choose to punch you in the face right now?
I don't mean that we choose who we're attracted to.
Really?
Okay, both of you, stop. Todd, do you like gay sex?
He wouldn't know. He's never had any.
What? No. Really?
I can't. It makes me think of poop. I don't like poop. The smell, the image, the sound, the texture, not that I've ever touched it. Oh, God, even thinking about poop makes me want to vomit.
Does thinking about vomit make you want to poop?
Oh, hey, no one likes poop.
I could offer an anecdote to the contrary.
What about Jerry? You at least gave him a blowjob.
For a few seconds. It was more of a blow consultation.
Maybe you're bisexual.
No, I'm sorry. This is recalculous. Todd, you cannot decide that you're straight just because you don't like the gay people you've been meeting.
I like girls. I've always liked girls. They're pretty and they're clean and they're soft.
You can find all of those qualities in a decorative pillow.
No, you can't. They're not always soft. That's why they're not called functional pillows. And for two, they're not always clean unless you steam them.
Todd, I think you're missing the point.
No, you're missing the point. I'm undergoing a severe sexual identity crisis and neither of my only two friends are taking me seriously.
Okay. I'm sorry. I support you. So does Ryder.
Yay.
Thank you. Because I do need your help. I'm still a little bit scared of the P word.
Hello?
No, you know.
Meow.
Okay, Todd. You can't say the word pussy. You're definitely gay.
I can say it. I just think it's vulgar.
Then say it.
Pussy.
Todd, say, I want to fuck some pussy.
I want to fuck some pussy. I'm straight.
I'm straight. I'm straight. I like bean burritos and motorcycles and motorcycles and pussy. Come here a lot?
What?
I said, do you come here a lot?
Oh, I thought you said, do I come a lot?
That's not what I said.
Yes, on both accounts. My boyfriend is a god.
Well, as long as he doesn't support religious genocide.
You're so cute. My friend Tracy would love you. Tracy!
Somebody rang?
Is anybody sitting here?
No. I'm completely alone.
Are you all right?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
My best friend from home was supposed to fly into LA for my birthday, but then some pigeon ran into the engine.
Oh my god, avian ingestion? That's literally my third worst nightmare. What was the death count?
What? No, it just got delayed, but then now I have no one to buy me drinks.
Well, I can buy you a drink.
Really? Do you want to be my birthday buddy?
Okay.
Yay! Let's do shots. My mama wanted me to go to Ohio State, but I was like, I'm turning 18. That's 40 in pop star years.
Wait, how old are you now?
18. But don't worry, my mom installed me with Southern values. I do not hook up. Like the Kelly Clarkson song, I do not hook up.
Instilled.
What?
And I think Ohio's in the Midwest.
What are you trying to say?
So you shouldn't have Southern values.
Oh yeah, you're right. I'm in LA now. You've like done this before, right?
Oh yeah. Yeah, lots of times.
Okay, good. Me too. So many times.
Oh god, what is that?
What's wrong?
Oh my god! Get up. It was like that scene in Alien, after they ate dinner with the, you know that scene? Well, I don't pay you to laugh at me.
Your parents pay me.
Yeah.
Frankly, Todd, I'm surprised by your behavior. You're willfully barking up the wrong tree, but I'm unclear as to what you're even chasing. Is it sex? Is it love? What do you want?
I don't know what I want. I know what I don't want. I don't want to be alone for the rest of my life.
Excuse me, do you work here?
Tell me you don't love me. Tell me you don't love me, and I'll let you get on that Korean Air flight and never look back.
My whole life, I've been waiting for you to appear in my life and make me whole.
That was good, Rory. I think she should be crying in the scene, though. So take a minute, and then we'll try again.
Okay.
And I see on your special skills, you can do a Zooey Deschanel impression. I'd love to hear it.
It's so soft, I can't believe it's not cotton. I'm probably gonna take that off.
Do you have any other questions before we give this another whirl?
No. No, I mean, yes. Are you really asking, or is that just an obligatory gesture?
I'm really asking.
This isn't a comedy, right?
No.
So, Jenna has a genius IQ. It says she's runway gorgeous and she studies jiu-jitsu. I am having some trouble understanding why she'd be attracted to Jonah, who doesn't work out and he's unemployed, and they have absolutely nothing in common.
Remember, Jenna has a troubled past.
Right, yes, dead dad, which I get, because I have that, so I can understand if it was like a whole solace, I just want to fuck the pain away kind of thing, although you'd think with all her CIA training, she'd have developed some equanimity. But she chooses to stay with him in Wisconsin over potentially thwarting a North Korean nuclear missile crisis. I mean, that's a lot.
People do crazy things when they're in love.
Okay, now you're just quoting Hercules.
Right. You done cleaning up?
Yes. Yeah, I am. Again, I'm so sorry that I was late. My audition ran really long, and then the 405 was back
up. No, don't even worry about it. Yeah, I'm firing you.
What?
I would have fired you when you got in, but Jamie called in sick and we were shorthanded.
Why didn't you fire Jamie?
I like Jamie. And you clearly don't want to be a waitress, so.
Who the fuck wants to be a waitress? The food here sucks.
Is the seat taken?
Does it look like it's taken?
Don't deflect. Move the story forward.
Okay. No. Would you like to join me for a cup of Joe?
Have I seen you somewhere before?
Maybe. Are you familiar with the filmography of Lars von Trier?
So you're an actress.
Do you want my autograph?
Have you ever done the sex scene?
Does rape count?
No.
Okay, Rory. We're not gonna tell you what you can and can't say. We're not the PC police. But rape is never funny.
I thought it was funny.
I didn't laugh.
Okay, well, it's not like I was mocking rape victims. I was mocking actors.
Uh-huh. Not everybody can make that distinction.
Well, it's not my fault if people are fucking stupid.
My best friend was date raped in college. That made me feel really uncomfortable.
See, Rory, it's different for people who've actually been affected by sexual abuse.
Yes, I would know, thank you.
If you need to talk to someone, my best friend really loves her therapist.
Your date rape friend?
No, Colleen moved to Boston. We don't really talk anymore.
Hey, Karen, it's your daughter. I was calling to chat. How's Sri Lanka? I hear they have great... What do they have in Sri Lanka? Anyway, I'm trying to be less negative, so I'm gonna sandwich technique this for you. It didn't rain. So that's positive. I got fired, and everybody in my improv class thinks I'm a huge bitch, and I got a parking ticket, and I think there's a dead mouse in my garbage disposal. So that's my negative thing. That's all 24 hours, so that counts as one thing. And positive. What's positive? Oh, I thought I saw Amy Adams at Trader Joe's. But it was just Isla Fisher. So I'm out here living the dream. Hey, you know that saying, shoot for the moon, even if you miss, you'll land among the stars? I did some research, and apparently the closest star, excluding our sun, is still 4 light years away from Earth. So if you miss the moon, you don't land on anything, ever. You just float aimlessly in space until you die. Okay, so call me back sometime or whatever. Bye.
Excuse me, do you work here?
No, but I get that a lot. I don't know why.
You're restocking the shelves.
Oh, some of the books are out of order.
Yeah, but it's not your job.
Valid. Counterpoint, I was at Staples the other day and somebody asked me if we sold paperweights and I wasn't doing anything. I was just standing there.
Were you wearing a red shirt?
No.
I know what your problem is. You have a very friendly demeanor. Like, you look super helpful.
Can I fix that?
Yeah, sure. Don't make eye contact, don't smile. The more you can project an air of antipathy, the less you'll be approached. It's not a hobby, it's a way of life.
I'm ignoring you.
It's convincing.
I can practice later. Sorry, am I in your way? Everything's sort of in disarray at the moment. I mean, it gets worse before it gets better.
No, you're fine. The library's hiring. I wanted to drop off my resume to a corporeal entity, if possible.
Good word. Corporeal.
Thank you.
And antipathy, you said that earlier.
Yeah, that's one of my go-to smart people words.
So you're a smart people what?
You know that handful of words that you overuse in conversations to impress strangers, even if they don't really fit? Like, my worst offenders are emblematic and perspicacity. You don't do that, do you? Okay. I'm sorry, ignore me. I am pretentious, apparently.
My middle name is pretentious.
What?
So, Raven Steven.
Is that a joke? Like, danger is my middle name.
No, my middle name is Preston. It's a pretentious name. I'm trying to relate to you.
Right. Preston is pretentious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some would say that it is Preston-chiss.
Would they?
If it's the joke, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Copy.
My first name is Todd.
Hi, Todd. I'm Rory.
Oh. I like that name.
Thank you.
It reminds me of Rory Gilmore.
You watch Gilmore Girls?
I watch Gilmore Girls. I own all the 7 seasons on DVD.
I own all 7 seasons on DVD.
I almost went to Yale because of that show.
I almost went to Yale because of that show. I didn't get in, obviously.
I did. That sucks. I'm sorry. Oh, favorite Rory boyfriend on 1, 2, 3.
Jess. Obviously.
Do you think I'm gay?
Pardon?
One can like Gilmore Girls and be not gay.
I wasn't assuming anything.
Okay. Because both my friends think I'm gay, so I didn't want you to. Last week I had sex with a girl. Well, woman. Well, girl.
Good for you.
Sorry, I don't know why I said that. I'm not bragging. I only got my hand in. Not because she was gay, or I'm gay, because she was a virgin and...
Fine, really. I believe you.
Oh. I just didn't want you to label me, so...
I don't... Labels are for vegans, as I sometimes say.
I eat meat. I feel bad for the animals. I prefer to eat smaller animals, like chickens, because the smaller you are, the less likely you are to feel pain.
I don't know that.
It might not be true. I haven't looked into it thoroughly. I already have a lot of guilt on my plate, so...
Hmm?
What?
Oh, nothing. I thought maybe you wanted to ask me something.
So you said you're an actress. Have I seen you in anything?
Maybe. Have you seen Two Girls, One Cup?
No. When did it come out?
Oh, I'm just kidding. Sorry. I hate that question.
When did it come out?
No. Have I seen you in anything? It's like you haven't. But anyway, it's a porn video.
You were in a porn video?
No. Two Girls, One Cup is a porn video. Have you never... Really? Oh. Well, it's two girls and then they shit into a cup.
Oh, no. Yeah. If you
I'm
could,
sorry.
No, just change. I'm a visual person. Change the topic.
Okay,
please.
Sure.
Yeah.
Great. What do you do?
Well, I get intrusive thoughts, so I keep replaying that imagery over and over in my head.
For work. What do you do?
Software coding. And I house sit as a side hobby, but mostly just to meet people.
Who do you meet house sitting?
The owners. Before they leave.
Oh. Whose house is this?
My first cousin once removed, chiropractor's ex-wife.
And what does she do?
I didn't ask. You have a very symmetrical face.
Thank you.
I'm developing an app called Face Value that leverages machine learning to measure facial bilateral symmetry on a scale of 1 to 10. You can tell a lot about a person by their face.
Yeah, what does my face say?
Oh, I'm glad you asked. Facial symmetry indicates extroversion.
Sometimes.
Lower levels of neuroticism.
Nope.
And developmental stability.
Definitely not.
It's true, they've done studies.
Well, to invalidate that research, I don't have a dad. My mom was, she still is, a surgeon for Doctors Without Borders, so she was always gone. And my brother basically raised me, except he got addicted to heroin and he stole a bunch of money from my Nana. We kind of don't talk anymore. It's a bit fucked up. Why am I telling you this?
I don't know.
I do. I have a theory that millennials overshare because we're the most godless generation. So that's why we confess everything on social media. It's sort of our way to cling to some kind of permanence.
Are you on social media?
No. Are you?
No.
Hmm. Well... It's just a theory.
Oh, I see it now.
What?
Your drug addict brother. Is it right?
So what's your face value?
6.2.
Oh, that doesn't sound good.
It's not. I have a deviated septum, a triangle of moles on this side, and then only one dimple.
That's ironic, you know? Guy obsessed with symmetry has crooked face. You must hate yourself.
Yeah, most of the time.
Oh, no, I didn't mean... No, I don't... I'm just fucking with you. Don't hate yourself. That's sad.
Okay.
So you're legit... OCD, right? You're not just like, oh, I'm so OCD, I save all the Red Skittles for last.
Oh, I do save the Red Skittles for last.
Huh?
But I'm also a checker and a washer, and I don't fly.
You don't fly? How do you get anywhere?
Well, I don't need to go anywhere.
Paris.
Small fridges.
New York.
I can drive to New York.
Have you?
No, but I've seen Taxi Driver in Cloverfield, so I get the idea.
You know driving is way more dangerous than flying, right?
Not the way I drive.
Do you see a psychiatrist?
Yes, but mostly I see a psychoanalyst because I like to talk a lot. And I used to do cognitive behavioral therapy to help with my phobias.
What are you afraid of?
Everything under the sun. The sun.
You're afraid of the sun?
Yeah, I try to avoid it, especially during the hours of 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. when the UV rays are the most potent, because I'm afraid it's going to expedite my cancer.
Oh, wait, you have cancer?
Oh, not yet, but I will.
You will?
Mm-hmm. There's a 44% chance that I'll develop some form of cancer throughout my lifetime, and I've never been exceptionally lucky.
But you need serotonin. Sunlight's good for your soul.
I know. I don't get enough, and it stresses me out. And the worst part is that stress causes cancer.
It's a vicious cycle.
It really is.
So, are you afraid of dying too soon or just dying in general?
The latter. I don't want to die, ever.
Oh, see, I'm the opposite. I already know how I want to die. I am 90, and I just won my second Oscar. I used to say third, but I don't want to be unrealistic. And I fall asleep hugging a panda, and then she falls asleep. And then she rolls over and accidentally smothers me.
Oh, that sounds nice.
But I can understand not wanting to die prematurely, because, like, if I died now before I'd done anything, you know, like, significant, I would be livid.
Well, I doubt many people would be jumping in their boots to die.
What happy people?
Except for suicidal people.
I don't hang out with those.
But they're probably not the jumping type.
I know some.
Unless it's off of a bridge or something.
But seriously, if I died now, I would literally kill somebody.
What, literally?
Well, no. Oh, no! Oh, God! That's one of my biggest pet peeves. I can't believe I just fucking did that.
Well, they say that things you don't like about other people are usually problems that you have with yourself.
Okay, first of all, who says that? Nobody says that. That is rude. Second of all, I did mean literally.
What, you literally kill somebody?
To be not dead? Yeah. Like, I'm not saying I'd go out and sign up to be a terrorist, but if somebody put a gun to my head and they said, hey, kill that guy or I'm gonna kill you, I'd be like, hey, sorry, man. I gotta look out for number one.
No matter who it was.
Well, maybe if it was like, no, I'd let Obama die.
Your parents?
They've had their time.
A baby.
I would definitely kill a baby.
What?
Oh, come on. Think about how much time and investment goes into raising a well-adjusted adult. I am college educated. Mm. I have a great sense of humor. I'm going to be a famous actress. I am way more beneficial to society than a useless, resource-consuming baby.
Wow.
It'd be like painting the Mona Lisa white to start fresh.
What if that baby was the next Picasso?
Yeah, more likely scenario. What if it was a gangbanger or a heroin addict or just had a real crooked face like you? I'm joking, Todd, I'm joking. I'm sorry, you're really easy. No, it's the same reason I don't want to have kids. I figure Murphy's Law, if I had kids, I'd probably end up like the mother. We need to talk about Kevin.
Oh, I thought that was going to be one of those movies where they say the title somewhere in the dialogue. And I kept waiting for it to happen, and it never did, and it really bothered me.
Not the massacre itself, just the fact that nobody ever said we need to talk about Kevin.
No, it just wasn't right.
My mom wants me to have kids. She wants me to have kids, and she wants me to save the planet. And I'm like, fuck, can I just do what makes me happy? You know, like, isn't that why our forefathers bombed and pillaged other countries so that I could be happy? And as much as I pretend to give no fucks what my mother thinks, invariably the only way that I can justify being an actor, which is like the epitome of vanity, is to be a disgustingly rich philanthropist like Paul Newman. And trying to be Paul Newman all the time is way too much pressure.
Tell me about it.
What would you do? Would you shoot the baby?
I'd shoot the baby.
Thank you.
But if it was you or me, I'd shoot me.
Sorry.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah, sorry. It's just the wine and the cake, and we've been talking for 8 hours. Why are you so nice?
Oh, I'm not that nice.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
You're the nicest person in LA.
Really, I'm not. I lie to homeless people. I always have change. I just don't give it to them.
I think I'm depressed.
Well, that's okay. I'm depressed too.
I should lie down.
Well, if you feel like you're gonna throw up, don't.
Okay. I don't know why I'm here. I don't mean existentially, specifically LA. I hate meeting people. So, what do you do? I'm an actress. Oh, have I seen you in anything? Oh, go fuck yourself. No offense. Oh, I usually lie and say I'm a geospatial analyst or something, because the truth is, and I know
I know that all yuppies are miserable because we have these chimerical expectations that will inevitably falter to reality because we can't accept that we are not as special as we think we are. But I don't care about them. I care about me. And I was valedictorian in high school, which shouldn't mean anything except that it does. It means I was better than 87 other people. It was a small private school. You know, I honestly thought that I would be an outlier. Like that Malcolm Gladwell book, Outliers, that I read at the Starbucks across from CAA, but nothing ever fucking manifests, and I'm already old. When did that happen? And I know that they say it's who you know, or rather, who knows you, but nobody knows me. Nobody really knows me, and I keep going out for these stupid fucking student films where everything is a dream, and then I don't even get a call back, and I didn't even want it anyway, and I must be dreaming. I must be dreaming. I must be out of my fucking mind, and I am so poor.
Well, you're a great actress.
You've never even seen me act.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But I can just tell. I mean, you're smart, and you're funny, and you're clean, and that's all you need.
Stop it.
No, really. You have a star personality. You're like Katharine Hepburn.
The stage is real life, Buster. Ha 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 ha.
That was really good. Can I hold your hand?
You've reached Todd Culler. I'm sorry I missed you, but please leave your name, number, the time and date you called, and order, followed by any other pertinent information. I'll get back to you as soon as reasonably possible.
Hi, it's Rory. My number is 206-377-2616. It's like 2:30-ish on a Wednesday. And I have another call. Hold on. Oh, it's you. Okay, I'll talk to you in a second. Hello?
Hi, you called?
You called first.
Oh, right. You're still unemployed?
I just must have been a gentler way to phrase that, but yes.
Good. So a friend of one of my clients asked me to house sit for her while she's vacationing in Europe, but it's a bit of a drive, so I wanted to see if you were available.
She's driving to Europe?
No. What?
You lost me.
I'm house sitting in Monterey.
Oh.
But I can't drive for that long by myself or I'll fall asleep and die, so I wanted to see if you'd be interested in joining me. I'll pay you.
Okay.
Yeah? I didn't know if you could get away with auditions and all.
Why wouldn't you just hire someone more local?
I organize closets. I have great references.
Of course you do.
The only thing is, how do you feel about dogs?
Dogs?
Yes, dogs. I normally adhere to a strict no pets policy, but if you're with me, I could be persuaded. The deal breaker is that you have to be the poop picker up.
Stop. You had me at I'll pay you. Look right at me mm-hmm. and keep a straight face.
Okay.
And no frowning, because that's cheating.
Okay.
Okay. Baby!
Come on, man! You didn't even let me finish!
That was...
You suck. Okay. Your turn.
What's the line again?
Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile?
Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile?
Baby, I love you, but I just can't smile. Weak, weak choice.
Okay, okay.
Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile?
Baby, I love you, but I just can't smile. What the fuck was that? Are you trying?
Or... I am trying. I'm just not good at this game.
It's because you're self-conscious. Look, if you want to make me smile, you have to humiliate yourself in a way that isn't, like, cute or endearing. Have ugly, we'll travel.
Okay. Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile, yes? Yeah? Yeah.
That was a smile. I win.
You didn't smile on purpose, did you?
I don't know, maybe. Okay.
Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile?
Baby, I love you. But I just can't smile. Do you want to be my girlfriend?
I'm so glad to finally meet you. Todd has been MIA forever.
3 months.
Yeah, that's like 24 months in bitch years. And you didn't tell me that Rory's so pretty.
Oh, thank you. I mean, you look like a model.
I am a model. You clearly haven't heard anything about me. And this is my boo, Zane. He's also a model, but mostly underwear.
Hi, Zane.
So? Updates.
Good, good.
Well, we just got back from San Diego.
Professional house sitters.
Oh, fine.
Zane's from London at the Vernacular.
We also sit dogs. No cats.
I'm allergic. She just hates them.
I do.
We should tell Danny for the holidays. He's got that tiny wiener.
Okay, enough business. Rory, how did you two meet?
Well, it's kind of funny. Actually, Todd, do you want to tell it?
Well, you tell it better.
Stop. I love it already.
We met in the self-help section of the library. He was stocking shelves, so I thought he worked there. And I was looking for a job.
Oh, you found him instead.
So cute. All of it.
How did you and Zane meet?
Mutual group sex friends. Party. Rory, what do you do?
I'm a geospatial analyst.
She's an actress.
Well, I totally believed you. Do you have an agent?
Should I get one? Are they helpful?
Oh, my God, yes.
Can't book anything from that one.
I know. Sorry, I'm looking. Is anyone getting food?
Oh, we're on a cleanse, but you should try their artisan flatbread. My treat. I just want to smell it.
Oh, we shouldn't. We're having a pizza tomorrow night.
Can we do that Thursday?
Well, we're making Mongolian Thursday.
Right, right.
You plan it all yourself as in advance?
Well, it's our dock night.
Dock night? Is that some roleplay thing?
I enjoy spanking.
Every Thursday, we watch a documentary to keep our relationship cognitively stimulated.
This Thursday, we're watching The Story of the Weeping Camel because it's set in Mongolia, so we thought it would be ironic if we were eating Mongolian.
Well, it wouldn't be ironic. It'd be ironic if we were eating camel.
I don't think the Whole Foods sells camel.
Is that a joke?
Was it not funny?
It's okay.
Scale of 1 to 6.
Scale's 1 to 6.
Oh, my God. Who are you dressing up as for Ryder's birthday party?
Ryder's having a birthday party?
Yeah. The theme is iconic movie couples. I thought you'd be on that, like, Asian on rice. Didn't you get the Evite?
White on rice.
Yeah, but don't Asians eat more rice?
I didn't get the Evite.
Oh, well, you know Ryder. He's faggotful.
Are you making fun of my accent?
Oh, no, I'm saying he's faggotful because he's a fag who's forgetful.
You can't say fag in America.
Well, Todd made it up.
Is that right, Tom?
No, I...
Anyway, you have to come. Plus, Marcus Stafford will be there, and he would be a perfect talent manager for Rory.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, he's always saying that his clients are shit, but I'm sure he would love you. Fucking A. I feel like Sandra Bullock in The Blind Side, making dreams come true.
We need to go home. I think I left the toaster on.
You didn't leave the toaster on?
We could go home and play the game of life and turn off the toaster.
We're never playing that game again. You get too emotional. Also, the toaster is always off unless you put toast in it.
You don't put toast in a toaster.
I meant bread.
Well, you said toast.
You know what I meant, Todd.
The toaster is always on unless you unplug it, and I forgot to unplug it, so it's on.
You do not forget to unplug things, so either you're being paranoid or you're making up excuses to avoid going inside. Both are scenarios I refuse to accommodate.
Okay, fine. But if you get bored and you want to leave, just use a safe word.
What's a safe word?
I don't know. We haven't picked one yet. How about snollygoster?
It's not very discreet. How would I slip it into a sentence?
Honey, have you seen my snollygoster?
What's a snollygoster?
You're right. People ask questions.
I'm just saying, how funny would it have been if the fifth element had been Dick?
Oh, my God, Todd.
Ryder, happy birthday.
It has been so long. I think I thought you were dead. And you must be Rory.
Hi, nice to meet you.
You're Todd's girlfriend.
Yes.
How is that going?
It's a ball.
Super. Is that for me?
It is, yeah. Todd picks it out.
It's from Crate and Barrel.
Don't tell him that.
It's not from Crate and Barrel.
If you don't like it, there's a gift receipt.
You know what? I bet I'm gonna love it because our Todd here has the aesthetic tastes of a well-oiled woman.
Where should I put it?
That's what Todd said.
What?
What? The guest bedroom is down the hall. It's the second door on your right.
Okay. You're fine.
Oh, okay. I'm fine.
Okay, so, like, she's in on it then.
In on what?
You're Paul Newman and Cat on a Hot Tin Roof.
Oh, you got it. We were worried nobody would recognize us.
Oh, God. Todd, you must know that he was gay, right?
Paul Newman? No, he's not.
His character was gay. That's why they never had any sex.
I didn't pick up on that at all. I think you just see subliminal homosexuality
Todd,
even when it doesn't.
No. He was gay, okay? The film was made in the 50s, so Hollywood censored the gayness. And you would know that if you had ever read the fucking play.
I just like the movie.
Hey.
Oh. 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 Right. Todd. This is Trent. Trent. This is Todd.
Guess which movie couple we are.
Brokeback Mountain.
No.
Ugh. He's Butch Cassidy and I'm the Sundance Kid. Because I'm a total bottom.
Stop making Paul Newman gay, okay? There's no evidence.
Well, I heard he slept with James Dean.
He did.
No, he was married to Joanne for 50 years, and they were very happy.
Baby, is this your gay friend that's dating your girl?
That's the one.
Do you guys have sex, or?
I don't have to answer that.
That's a no.
We're just taking it slow.
And that's denial.
Ugh, pussies are gross. Semen for the win.
Todd doesn't like bodily fluids.
You know, pussies have juices, right? They spray at you, like Spider-Man.
You're making me uncomfortable.
Oh, I'm sorry. I have a big mouth.
He's not exaggerating.
I just think it's kind of sad that you haven't found yourself. It's a waste. He's cute, though, right? Hmm?
Yeah, he's okay.
Mm. I'm gonna go find Rory.
Okay. Baby, did you and Todd ever...
No.
That's
what
I thought.
Wow.
Oh. Rory.
Meg.
Come. Sit with us. You look so pretty. Who are you?
Oh, thank you. I'm Elizabeth Taylor from Cat on a
Hot Tin Roof? Oh, my God. Whoa. You and Todd have a bitchin' sense of humor.
I don't get it.
Okay, so Liz is married to Paul Newman, and shit hits the fan because he's secretly gay.
I don't think that's what happens.
Well, didn't you read the play? In the play, it's obvious that he has the hots for Skipper.
Well, I just like the movie.
Oh, because you said Todd is gay.
Oh, no, it's okay, it's okay. Todd told me everybody used to think he was gay.
We didn't just think he was gay. He was gay. Like, he went to gay bars. He had a gay eHarmony account. He sucked Jerry's gay willy willingly.
What?
Oh, just a tip. But that was before you. Don't worry. He's totally crazy about you.
Right, right, yeah. I know.
Can I ask you a personal question? How's Todd in bed?
Ugh, well, you know, great.
Ah, oh, I knew it. He's so attentive, right? I bet he's one of those guys who makes it all about pleasing you. Like, I literally have to drag Zane's tongue to my clit.
Well, maybe if you shaved,
Shut the fuck up. I had a skin infection, so I stopped. You want to talk, Bushy McPherson?
I love your sass.
I love your ass. God, I'm so funny. Todd?
We're doing cake, bitches.
Oh.
Let's go. Okay.
Rory, meet Marcus. He's a talent manager. Rory is a phenomenal actress.
Oh, she's never seen me act.
Yeah, you got a good look. I mean, you're attractive in an ordinary sort of way. The kind of thing you'd find at a Supercuts in Puerto Rico.
Thanks.
You know, one of my clients, she keeps nagging me. She's like, Marcus, you never send me out anymore. And it's like, baby, I try, but there's just only so many roles every year for a female troll. I'd drop her if she wasn't my niece.
It is ironic because rain on your wedding day is considered good luck, even though it's a logistical nightmare.
Rain is not good luck.
It's a cultural belief that a wet knot is harder to untie.
Fine, whatever. It doesn't matter. It's not ironic. It's a logical paradox. It'd be ironic if you were marrying a meteorologist named Sunny Weathers and he planned an outdoor summer wedding in Arizona and then it rained, but only if he set the date.
What if Sunny Weathers wanted it to rain because it's considered good luck and so his forecast was right? Is that ironic then?
What? Yes. No, no, Todd, it's still not.
Okay, fine. 10,000 spoons when all you need is a
knife. It's not ironic.
How can you say that? Like, if I work at a spoon factory and it's somebody's birthday and I made them a cake, but I forgot the knife, and I'm like, hey, does anybody have a knife? No, but ironically, we have 10,000 spoons.
No, because you should have remembered the knife. You wouldn't expect there to be a knife at a spoon factory. It's not ironic, it's just unfortunate. It would be ironic if it was a knife factory, they had a policy against using company knives for personal use, and then you had nothing to cut the fucking cake with, Todd. That would be ironic.
Well, I think you have a very narrow definition of the word ironic.
Look, you're missing the point. She's transpired an entire generation of adolescents who just casually toss the word around to the point where irony has lost its whole fucking meaning.
It hasn't lost its meaning, it's just evolved. Language is fluid.
Yeah, well, you'd be one to talk about fluidity.
Okay, and how would you like me to extrapolate that statement?
You know what's really ironic? Arguing about an Alanis Morissette song with your gay boyfriend.
I don't see the irony in that. And if that's an accusation, then I will have you know that Ryder is an unreliable source. Did you know that he cheated on his eye exam?
You can't cheat on an eye exam, Todd.
He did. He just memorized the letters.
Okay. Meg said, and I quote, you sucked Jerry's gay willy willingly.
Well, that is hearsay, and as such, it's inadmissible.
You're really not going to admit it.
No, I won't admit it because it was just a couple of licks and it didn't mean anything.
Oh my God, it means you're gay.
It means that I'm possibly bisexual if you feel obliged to pigeonhole me into a category of sexual identity that you can easily apprehend. Okay, fine, I admit that I've dabbled in male-on-male courting in the past, but I found it repulsive, and I'm with you now, and I chose you, and you're a woman. What else do you need to know?
Why haven't you ever tried to have sex with me?
I don't like bodily fluids.
You can't use your OCD as an excuse for everything.
Just because you can control your brain doesn't mean it's a universal skill set, and I don't recall you attempting to sex me either, and have I accused you of being a lesbian?
Yeah, well, it's different for me.
Why is it different for you?
Because.
Because why?
Because you are supposed to be the man.
Well, that's really sexist, and frankly, you should feel offended.
Todd. We have been dating for 6 months, and you haven't even tried to fondle my boobs. This is not normal.
Well, being normal is vastly overrated.
Oh my God, you're quoting Sabrina the Teenage Witch. You are so gay.
It's Halloween town.
Whatever, still gay.
Fine, there. Does that make you happy?
No, God, stop it.
And what do you want?
I want a real relationship.
This is a real relationship.
No, no. This is playing house. Our names are not on the lease, and even if we were married, it would be annulled because there's been no fucking consummation.
Well, that's redundant.
What?
Fucking consummation is redundant.
Focus, Todd.
Sorry, fine, let's do it.
What?
Sex, let's do the sex.
Right now?
No, not now. I'm hardly in the right frame of mind right now.
Tonight then, I guess?
Yeah, okay, tonight.
Okay. It's tonight.
It came so fast.
It does it.
I'm just gonna take a shower first.
Thank you.
There you go.
Aww. Okay. I think we need to talk about the elephant in the room.
The white elephant?
Sure. Yeah, the color doesn't really matter.
Well, the phrase is the white elephant in the room.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. It's derived from the short story Hills Like White Elephants.
Wait, what?
By Ernest Hemingway?
Yeah, no, I know. I've read it. Do you know what that story's about?
Abortion.
Okay, yes.
But they never explicitly say the word abortion. It's the white elephant in the room, the thing nobody wants to talk about.
No, you're mixed up. The white elephant is the unborn baby.
Well, unborn baby abortion, I think you're arguing semantics.
No, it's not semantics. The elephant in the room is the thing nobody wants to talk about. The white elephant is an unwanted possession that's a bitch to get rid of. You're, like, mixing two separate idioms.
What? Are you sure?
Yes.
So then what's
the word? Don't forget the fucking elephants. We need to talk about sex.
So sex is the white elephant.
No, it's the elephant in the room.
Okay, I'm sorry. Why are you getting so angry?
Because you're not listening to me.
I am listening. I'm just confused.
You're confused. I'm confused. Do you want sex?
Only if you do.
Okay, well, I don't.
Okay, good.
Great.
Wonderful.
I realize that I may have undermined your OCD. I just have to accept that you don't like bodily fluids, so maybe sex isn't on your agenda. And for me, I mean, we know that I think intercourse is a primitive national pastime that's been overblown by the media and popular culture.
And copulation is only intended for reproduction, and we both hate babies.
So really the question is, why do we want to ruin our relationship with sex?
We don't.
I concur. Also, objectively, to a random bystander who didn't know we were having intimacy problems, we look just like Paul and Joanne.
And who cares what society thinks anyway?
Right?
And it would be ridiculous to say that we're just best friends. I mean, we live together, we sleep together, we kiss sometimes with tongue, your crumbs are falling.
Sorry.
It's okay, I'll vacuum later. And you give great back massages, which, let's be honest, is basically comparable to an orgasm anyway.
And you know, maintaining routine, passionate sex is a hurdle for any couple. When you think about it, we're just throwing in the towel early.
Exactly. I mean, 65% of married couples stop having sex after 10 years.
Really?
I don't know, I just made that number up.
Well, it sounds like a real statistic.
It does, doesn't it?
I'm so glad we had this talk.
Me too. Oh, so sex is the white elephant, because it's
the thing we want to get rid of. Okay, okay. That's true, you're right. Are you happy?
Yes.
And why do you think that is?
Because if you love someone enough, you can change. The other day I was rereading The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up, and I accidentally ripped page 138, and it didn't even bother me that much.
Good for you.
I did get rid of the book, but only because it was no longer bringing me joy. Anyway, Rory makes me a better person. I'm not crying, my hand eczema is gone, I'm watching more documentaries. It's so funny to think I was in here just 6 months ago complaining about how I was going to be alone forever. What a hoot.
You know, Todd, I have to admit, when I told you to experiment with your heterosexual inklings, I wasn't sure it was the best idea, but you actually may be somewhat straight, like a Kinsey 3.
Thank you. That means so much coming from you.
You're welcome. Will you be spending Thanksgiving with your parents?
I will, yes, and I'm bringing Rory.
How exciting. Please remind them that they still owe me for September. I sent them an invoice.
Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you, I'm Topanga.
Nice to meet you, Topanga.
We're so happy.
Rory,
to have you.
Come on in.
Come on.
Take off your shoes.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, she doesn't have to do that right away.
Come on, there.
Okay, so when can we expect grandkids?
Mother.
What? Rory is the first girl that you brought home. It's my cultural duty to torment you in front of her.
Oh, but we don't want children.
They bring you unhappiness.
No, don't be so self-deprecating, Todd. We forgive you.
It's true. They've done studies.
Parents report statistically lower levels of happiness and marital satisfaction compared to non-parents.
That's funny. I don't recall filling out a survey.
Mm. Oh, well, not all parents, I'm sure. I'm sure you guys are outliers.
But I can't handle irrational behavior or crying or poop.
Well, having kids fills your life with purpose.
But does that intangible sense of purpose outweigh the burden of lost sleep, time, and income, or are you justifying your actions?
I have no buyer's remorse. You were the second best decision I ever made.
What was the first?
Investing in Google.
What am I?
You're the fourth.
Well, we have everything we need. Why would we purposefully follow a path that could obstruct our personal happiness?
Because there are some things in life that are more important than personal happiness.
Like what?
I don't know, honey. Why don't we just ask our friend Socrates?
Or Gandhi.
Maybe Harriet Tubman would know.
That little blonde kid in Pay It Forward.
Oh, I love him. Whatever happened to that kid?
Okay, point made.
All right, here's why you have kids. Now, you're both healthy, intelligent, valuable contributors to society. So you have a biological imperative to pass on those genes because you know who's ruining this country? The Mexicans.
Wally.
Okay, Dad, can we save the racism until after dessert?
What? I'm not saying that all Mexicans are stupid. I'm just saying, and there's plenty of literature to back me up on this. Mm-hmm. There is an inverse correlation between intelligence and fertility. And guess who's popping out the most babies?
Mexicans.
Bingo. And you all know who's the smartest race.
Asians.
Goddamn right.
What he means is you would both make excellent parents.
No. No, what I mean is everything that's ultimately wrong with the world is caused by stupidity, so smart people have an obligation to combat reverse Darwinism.
Then why am I an only child?
You were enough.
Rory, name a social issue.
Don't encourage him.
AIDS.
AIDS wouldn't even exist if some fucking idiot didn't have sex with a monkey.
That is, what?
Okay, you know how I'd eradicate stupid people?
Sarin gas.
No, how?
This is what I would do. Every male should have a vasectomy at birth, just a little snip-snip. In order to qualify for a reverse vasectomy, the couple in question would have to pass a series of aptitude tests.
Okay, no, that's actually genius.
No, that is completely unethical. You cannot advance society by debasing natural human rights.
And what I'm saying is that having children shouldn't be a right, it should be a privilege.
Amen.
Okay, ethics aside, implementation would be impossible. No government could ever get
away with it. Todd, stop being so pragmatic. He's obviously being hypothetical.
Listen to your girlfriend, son.
Okay, hypothetically, this would be a repressive caste system. There would be a proletarian revolution.
You're right. Instead of abortion clinics, we would have pregnancy clinics.
Would that change the meaning of pro-choice?
Ooh, and you just know that there'd be some skeezball on Skid Row with a trench coat who was like, hey, you want to buy some sperm? It's probably not even human sperm.
That's disgusting.
Okay, I have a hypothetical. What if a very smart and beautiful woman married just stupid man?
Are you trying to say something? No, it is true. She's just with me for the sex.
Oh, honey, come on, not in front of the kids.
Oh, come on. Todd is a big boy now. He should know that his old man still pitches like Roger Clemens.
Yes, he does.
Mm. Is that a basketball person?
Mm. Oh, hi. Mm. Mm. So thankful. Mm. Oh, God, look at that. Tiny boy. Todd, you used to be so cheerful. What happened?
He was just that sweetest little baby. Oh, my God, this reminds me. I think it's in the garage, honey. We have a video of Todd doing the Macarena to Building a Mystery, and he called it that. No, this is the best. He called it the Sarah McLaugherina.
Oh, Topanga, can we find that?
Oh, gosh, I'm going to send Wally out to look for it.
Oh.
Oh, wait, look at this one. That's in Venice. Where are you going, to, Sweeney? I have more.
You seem well. You taking your meds?
Yes.
That girl is something else. You really hit the jackpot.
Thank you.
Todd, I,
Dad?
I'm proud of you. Just want you to know that.
Are your hands getting tired?
No, I can keep going. Did my dad seem unusually nice to you?
Yeah, he's awesome. Your mom is doubly awesome because she's 50% less racist.
Yeah. I know this is my anxiety talking. I always thought my parents loved me unconditionally, and tonight it felt like they loved me more. Like they were relieved that you were a girl. And I kept thinking that if I brought a boy home, it wouldn't have been like that. They wouldn't have used a good jar, the turkey would have been dry. My dad wouldn't hug me, he'd just shake my hand. I know, why am I thinking that, right? Stupid brain.
Okay, my turn. I think they're just happy that you're happy.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Todd.
Meg.
Rory. Merry holidays.
We brought fluffer nutters.
Bitchin'. You can put them next to the jello shots. Don't spaz, but write about Jerry.
Jerry who?
Blow job Jerry, but don't spaz. I'm sure he won't say anything you don't want him to say.
God, this is so awkward, right?
Is it?
You know, Todd is such a sweet guy. I'm so happy for you guys. I guess he didn't like me, but whatever. What are you gonna do, right?
Mm-hmm. And you are here with...
Ryder. Yeah. He invited me last minute. You know, I didn't think he liked me either. He usually doesn't even respond to my texts. But you know what? I bet somebody else bailed, and he just invited me because he knew I'd be available.
Tonight should be fun, though.
Sybil Shepherd.
Ellen Generous.
No, that joke.
Ellen Generous.
Heath Ledger. Judy Garland.
Ellen DeGeneres.
Ruth Ellen DeGeneres. No, Ellen DeGeneres.
Could be.
Tracy Chapman.
Ellen DeGeneres.
Yes.
Yep. Hey, there you go.
Damn it.
2862. We beat you so bad.
You didn't do anything.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Whose idea was it to have fucking Will and Grace on the same team?
You know, I've actually never seen Will and Grace.
They are so cute.
Yeah, keep dreaming, Jerry.
Well, we could play a different game. I brought Bananagrams and Exploding Kittens, and I tried to bring Scene at Turner Classics Edition, but this one confiscated it.
It's not fun when you know all the answers.
It's fun for me.
Okay, fuck all of those options. I'm the hostess, and I've decided we're gonna play a grown-up game. Truth or Dare.
Dare, baby, pick me, I pick Dare.
Zane. I dare you to strip naked and let me draw flowers all over your body.
Fine. Oh, wow. Come on, then. Ryder, truth or dare?
Dare, obviously.
I dare you to spank Jimmy's ass.
It's Jerry.
You heard the man, Jimmy. Get your sweet tush over here.
Okay.
I did not.
Oh, and a bad, bad boy, Jerry. All those nights alone.
Yeah, I live alone.
God. Yeah, this is what you like, isn't it?
Okay,
isn't
that one is too hard.
There we go.
Whew. So fun.
Meg, truth or dare?
Please.
I dare you to give everyone at this party a lap dance.
Oh, my God. Yes. Alexa, play a slut playlist.
Yes. Oh my God.
Okay. Oh. Yeah.
You like this baby?
Yeah.
Todd? Yeah.
Todd, is he?
Oh God. Okay. Yep. That's him.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, sorry. I just have an eyelash
in my eye. I'm just kidding.
Bye, Rory.
Fuck. I'm horny.
I think we all are.
You want to do the same?
Not that horny, Jerry.
Mm-hmm.
sweater is green. My sweater is green. My skirt is beige. The walls are gray. The door is...
Truth. Have you and Rory...
I mean, Dare.
Afraid of the truth, Todd? Stand up. Just do it. I dare you to switch clothes with me. You have to play, Todd.
Let me.
Todd? I have a headache. I think it's all that snollygoster.
I'm in the shower.
Can I come in?
What?
In the shower, could I come in?
Well, I have a bristle body back brush, so I can reach everywhere. It might be counterproductive.
Please. I won't look, I promise.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Can't you tell?
Well, I think so, but...
It should be obvious.
You shouldn't.
I know.
Okay, stop. Stop acting.
Like now or in general?
You tell me. Are you getting cast? Is this routine working for you?
I think you have a Trojan.
Impossible. I only bareback. My nickname in college was literally bareback rider.
That's really unsafe.
Yeah, it's also a joke, Todd. I read the Iliad.
The Trojan horse wasn't in the Iliad.
Okay. I skimmed the Iliad.
Keep shutting me down. What do you do on the internet?
Do you really want to know?
No.
Are you sure you might like it?
I'm sure we don't like the same things.
Okay, keep telling yourself that, Todd.
Okay, you know what? You can fix this.
I would if I could, but...
I don't know what your problem is.
I thought that you said it was a Trojan.
Yes, it's the Trojan. I don't know what your problem is with me.
Do you really want to know?
Yes.
My problem with you, Todd, is that you are trying so hard to be something that you're not, and it's offensive.
Oh, I offend you?
Yes, you offend me. You are not bisexual, Todd, and it's gays like you who can't get over their internalized homophobic shame that reinforce society's idea that actual bisexuality is a myth.
Why do you even care? You're not bisexual.
I've slept with bisexuals.
So?
Rory is not your girlfriend, Todd. She's your fucking Katie Holmes.
Well, I love her.
No, you think you love her, but you are going to break that poor girl's heart.
Yeah, you'd like that, wouldn't you?
Right, because I'm the asshole in this situation.
Well, you are what you eat.
And when'd you get to be so clever, Todd?
I've always been clever. What are you doing?
Can't you tell?
Well, I think so, but...
I mean, it should be obvious.
You shouldn't.
I know.
I mean, I really wish you wouldn't.
You should have thought of that.
Is it because of what I did?
Partly, yes. Mostly, no.
Stop doing that and really listen to me.
You don't recognize no, do you?
I'm just asking you to listen.
I said no.
Irrational, but that doesn't mean it would never happen.
No, it's more than irrational, Todd. It's paranoia. Nobody has ever been murdered because they registered as an organ donor.
I didn't say that I think I'm going to be murdered. I said as soon as I register as an organ donor, I think I'm going to die.
Why?
Because it would be ironic. Surely you
oh
can appreciate
God.
That. Also, I don't like the idea of my organs in somebody else's body. It's like when different foods touch.
Okay. I need a kidney. And you're a perfect match.
You're typo. I can't give you a kidney. You can give me a kidney.
Hypothetically, if you could save my life with one of your organs, would you?
Hypothetically, yes.
Realistically? Todd, just leave it. Todd. Todd. Todd.
Nothing.
Hey, come on. How about now?
We could try an open relationship, if you think that would help.
What if I have homosexual anxiety OCD, so I have an obsessive irrational fear of being gay, but I'm actually straight? Or what if my fear of being gay has nothing to do with my OCD, but I have an ego dystonic sexual orientation, meaning I just don't want to be gay because it conflicts with my idealized self-image perpetuated by popular culture? Or what if I'm a heteromantic asexual, so I'm romantically attracted to women, but sexually attracted to nobody? And the thing is, when I say them out loud, they all sound right, but what if I'm none of the above?
Do you remember what happened when your father took you to Disneyland and tried to force you onto a roller coaster?
Yes, of course, I was there.
What happened?
I started screaming that he was kidnapping me and he almost got arrested and we never went back.
You can lead a horse to water.
But you can't make it get on a roller coaster or try anal sex. I get it, I'm the horse. But am I a gay horse? Am I a straight horse or am I a Shetland pony? Which is basically a gay horse. Ugh, that's what Ryder would say if he was here. See, he's in my head. Will you please just, like, tell me what I am?
Well, why don't we just start with the basics? Are you sure you're a boy?
Well, I was until now.
It's interesting.
Rory? Oh my God, it is you. Hi. Wow, this is Crazy Flakes.
Hi.
Nicole Shaw from Belmont High. I know. I look totally different. Yeah. Nose job. I got a nose job.
Oh.
So, wow, here you are auditioning. I didn't even know you were an actress. Did you do plays in high school?
No, not really.
Did you?
Yeah, I was in every play.
Right, you were, yeah.
So how long have you been in L.A.? Are you booking a lot, or...?
Oh, well, I'm actually not supposed to say anything, but I'm the new face of the Squatty Potty.
Nice! Wow, yeah, I booked 2 nationals this year. So it's like, hell yeah, no more day job.
What was your day job?
Oh, no, I'm just being facetious. I never had one. Thank God, you know?
That's not really facetious.
Oh, you're so sweet.
No, I mean... How'd you pay rent?
I live with my boo, and he's in banks or something. So that's super convenient. And, you know, my parents will help me if I max out my card. They love me too much to see me suffer. People think that all we do is memorize lines, but acting is really the hardest job there is.
I don't know about that.
No, it is.
It's emotionally exhausting, sure, but it's not like a heart transplant.
If you're doing it right, it is.
Hey, Janice, here's those files you wanted.
Great. Nicole, will you just stick around for a little bit?
Oh, of course, yeah.
Thank you so much.
Rory.
That's all we need. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Great job.
You're really loud.
Oh, thank you so much. Bye.
Seattle.
Well, you can't be an actress in Seattle.
Well, apparently I can't be one here either.
Not with that attitude.
Todd, I am too smart to keep investing my life in a career and a relationship that is going nowhere.
Lucille Ball.
What about Lucille Ball?
Lucille Ball didn't make it big until she was 40.
Oh my God.
I mean, what if she had given up? Can you imagine that?
Why are you packing?
You could have your own show. I love Rory.
Yeah, and then you can be my heavily accented straight man.
Yeah.
No, Todd, come on. Todd, if you don't want me to go, why are you packing?
I don't know.
Those aren't my clothes.
I know.
Todd, we can do better. We both deserve more.
I don't want more. I'm happy.
I'm not.
Well, that's your fault, not mine.
Todd, next week, or maybe 5 years from now, you could meet the right guy. You could. And maybe that's someone who doesn't want to touch your butt. Or maybe you learn to like it. I don't know, but I can't just sit around and wait for you to hurt me.
Why would I hurt you when I love you?
I don't think that you can love somebody else until you love yourself.
Well, I love myself when I'm with you.
Todd, this isn't one of our debates. You can't win.
What if this is as good as it gets? Like that movie, as good as it gets.
Sometimes something's gotta give, like that movie. The Day After Tomorrow.
Well, can you just tell me what you want? So I can try?
I want my own apartment that accurately represents one third of my income. And I want my own friends that are less attractive than me. And I want simultaneous orgasms. And those are things you can't give.
You said you didn't want sex.
Yeah, I changed my mind.
Well, that's not loud.
Maybe one day I want kids. Todd, I'm sorry. I don't want kids. I don't want kids, Todd. That was stupid. I don't know why I said that. I'm sorry. Come on. Todd, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it. I hate babies. We know this, Todd. Come on. Okay. Todd, I need you to breathe. All right? Just breathe for me, okay? It's okay, Todd. It's okay. You're gonna be... Todd, I'm here, okay? I'm just gonna sit right here. But I need you to breathe, all right? I'm right here. I'm just gonna be right here.
People say that finding love is hard. Well, I did the math. There are 4 million people living in Los Angeles based off the 2010 census, approximately 8% of whom are men aged 20 to 30, 5 to 10% of whom identify as gay or bisexual. Of these 32,000 or less men, only 10% will have an IQ of 120 or higher, so we can eliminate the rest, let's be honest. Of the remaining 3,200, I will be sexually incompatible with most of them. While there are no conclusive studies on the number of gay men who abstain from penetrative sex, I'm assuming the number is less than 25%, especially in my generation, and I think that's generous. Now, of these 800 men, 30% will be in long-term relationships with each other, 60% will find me unattractive either because I'm Asian, because I have a crooked face, or because I'm generally incorrigible, and an additional 9% that can actually put up with me, I will reject outright over various breakers, including but not limited to snoring, poor dental hygiene, and or bad taste in movies. That only leaves 8 potential soulmates on the high end, and after calculating the binomial distribution for randomly meeting any one of them on any given day over the next half century,
Todd.
And integrating the probability mass from 0 to 1 number of meetings,
Todd.
There is only a 0.0006% chance that I will ever fall in love, which is, as I'm sure you can guess, statistically insignificant.
Todd.
And I'm having more compulsions, so if you could please refer me to a cognitive behavioral therapist, I'd greatly appreciate it.
Why don't you call Dr. Leonetti?
I don't want him to know that I'm relapsing. He has a very high opinion of me. He said so in our last session.
Have you considered that your symptoms are being activated by emotional stress?
Oh, you think it's psychological. Well, I guess that's why my parents pay you the big bucks. I'm sorry. I know, I'm projecting.
If Rory was a man, would you still love her?
What do you mean?
If you met a man with all of Rory's qualities, her interests, her intellect, her sense of humor, would you consider this man your soulmate?
Yes, obviously.
Then, Todd, I think you might be gay. Like a Kinsey Five.
Okay, fine. I'm gay. Is that what you want to hear? Is that what the world needs to hear? I'm fucking gay? I don't have a problem with being gay. I have a problem with being alone for the rest of my life.
Well, then, I think we're making progress.
I mean, gay men have been marrying women since sliced bread.
I don't know what to tell you.
Maybe Rory's right. Maybe I don't love myself. Maybe I wouldn't have been loyal to her.
Ugh, now you're just being silly. You're like the definition of loyal. You're like that dog. Old Yeller.
Yeah, Old Yeller was loyal until he got rabies, and then Travis shot him in the face and he died.
I'm cheating on Zane.
What?
I've been sleeping with this other guy. His name's Ripper. He's beautiful. He has an accent.
Zane has an accent.
I know, but he didn't feel foreign to me anymore. Don't lecture me. I know it's fucked. Look, Todd, my point is, I love you, but I can't imagine spending more than 3 days with you at a time.
That's not a point.
Zane and I aren't best friends. We don't have doc night. We don't bananagram. We don't lose track of time by intense conversation. We do lose track of time by intense fucking. But for me, that's easy to come by. You know, I throw a penny, I hit a model. Can you say the same thing about Rory? Think about it.
Can we go inside now? Thank you. Excuse me, do you work here?
Hi, Karen, it's Rory. Just thought I'd drop you a line. Work is good. My boss wanted me to decorate my cubicle. Apparently, my lack of framed photographs is darkening her aura, so I photoshopped myself into a fashion spread with the cast of the OC, and then she was like, all of your friends are white. And I was like, I know, I'm sorry. Oh, in 23 days, I qualify for medical, which is great, because I can't hear certain frequencies in my left ear. I think I might have, like, an acoustic neuroma or something. I know, I sound like... Oh, I found this cool website called seeyourfolks.com, and apparently I'm going to see you 7 more times before you die. I did say you were living in the Philippines. I know that's temporary, but I think it might have skewed the results.
Okay. Call me back. Bye.
I keep telling them we need to get a second toaster. These traffic jams are driving me mad.
You should write up a cost-benefit analysis. When management sees this loss of employee productivity, surely they will cave to your demands.
So, what kind of bagel are you having?
Sesame.
Nice.
What kind of bagel are you having?
Garlic.
Lovely.
Well, I'm not planning on kissing anyone today, so. Are you?
Am I what?
Do you have plans to kiss anyone today?
Nope. Nothing on the calendar.
Hey, Rory.
Oh, hey, Craig.
Yeah, a bunch of us are gonna check out this new Thai place for lunch. It's not a party unless you're there.
Yeah. Okay, I like Thai.
Great. Yeah, we're about to head over.
For sure.
I'm just gonna finish this, and then I'll meet you guys there.
Don't work too hard, Rory Gilmore.
You watch Gilmore Girls?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I own, like, all the seasons on DVD.
Me too.
Hey, Craig, random question.
Hit me.
If somebody had a gun to your head and they said, kill this baby or I'm gonna kill you, what would you do?
What baby?
There's like a baby on the floor.
It's just lying on the floor.
Okay, it's on a shelf, but you have a gun and you can either kill the baby or you get shot.
Can't I just kill the guy with the gun pointed to my head?
No, he's too fast. He's like James Bond.
Why would James Bond make me kill a baby?
It's a hypothetical situation, Craig.
I mean, I guess I would save the baby. I mean, I don't think I could live with the guilt.
Yeah.
Why? What would you do?
Oh, I would save the baby. Obviously.
You're so funny, Rory.
Excuse me, do you work here?
Todd? What are you doing here? How did you find me?
Well, your landlord called me for a reference check. She had your employer info on file.
She just gave it to you?
Well, her English wasn't very good.
Yeah, I think she's Bulgarian.
I would have guessed Hungarian.
What's the difference?
Well, Hungarians can't make the sound.
The what?
The sound.
Okay, never mind. Todd, how did you even get to Seattle? Did you take a plane?
Yes. For you.
Really?
No, I drove. It took 3 days. I had to book a hotel in Sacramento and Medford. Look, you called me.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
My butt dialed you.
Well, I think your butt knows what your heart wants. I think you called me like that episode of Gilmore Girls where Lorelai calls Luke like that movie The Way We Were, where Barbara Streisand calls Robert Redford because she really needed her best friend.
Todd, this is too meta for me.
I'm your best friend. and I just want to be the way we were.
You know how that movie ends, right?
Yes, and it sucked, and that's why... And that's why...
Todd, what is this?
It's our song.
I have never heard this song in my life.
Well, every rainbow has to start somewhere.
What? Todd, how long have these people been out there? Were they one per tree? What if I didn't show up? What if I worked late? Or I snuck out the back and carpooled to Chipotle?
I don't know.
You're crazy.
People do crazy things
when
they're in love. Rory, I love you.
Get up!
I will
Todd.
Always love you. And I know that you're scared that I'm going to hurt you, so I'm giving you my guarantee.
I'm not going to ring one.
Rory, will you...
But no!
You didn't even let me finish.
No, I will not marry you!
Why?
I am not discussing the... Okay, they need to leave. Whoever they are. Do you know these people? Great. Okay. Hi. Excuse me, I'm sorry, but this is just a big misunderstanding. You're all very talented, but show's over. Okay, time to go home. All seven of you.
Okay, thank you. Drive safe.
Todd, I'm not ready for this. This is too soon.
Well, are you even happy here?
Overall, yes.
Oh. Well, do you love me?
No.
Look, I know that you're worried that I'm gonna meet the perfect guy someday, but I promise you that I won't, because he doesn't exist. Sure, we all like to think there's a soulmate out there for us who's going to complete us intellectually and physically and emotionally, but the harsh reality is not everybody gets that. So 2 out of 3 isn't so bad. I mean, if you're blind or schizophrenic or you're missing an arm and a leg, you might not even get 1 out of 3, and you just have to accept that. And I know that that's an offensive thing to say, but you agree with me. You agree with me. And anyway, I had accepted that I would never find anybody because I admit that I'm finicky. But then I met you, and I don't have to scour the ends of the earth to know beyond a reasonable doubt that you're the one. I already know. You're the only person I like arguing with, and you're the only person I don't mind losing to. And you're the only person I can't lose. And so maybe we won't have the greatest sex ever, but, you know, I mean, I can try harder. I mean, if Helen Keller can learn to talk, I can learn to eat you out. And I honestly think that we could be happy for the rest of our lives because I want to watch you die. I mean, I want to see you through to the end in sickness and in health. And you know that that says a lot because I don't like sickness or endings or poop. And you know this, but... You know, if you had cancer and you needed help, I mean, ideally I'll have a nurse to help deal with that, but if it was an emergency and you did number 2 in your pants, I would clean you up because I love you and I want you to be my wife.
I'm sorry.
Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile? Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile? Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile? Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile? And if you love me, Rory, come on! Baby, if you love me, won't you please just give me a smile? Sonder.
That's a great word.
I didn't have a moment of Sonder until last year.
That's okay. You have other good qualities.
Schadenfreude, obviously.
Or Jessica.
What's Jessica?
Jessica's when you replay a hypothetical dialogue over and over again in your head, like winning an argument or getting interviewed by Conan O'Brien.
There's a word for that?
There's a word for everything.
I wonder if there's a word that exactly describes the feeling when you learn there's a word that exactly describes what you're feeling.
If there is, I bet it's French.
What are we talking about?
Specific words to describe obscure emotions.
Oh. Déjà vu.
We already said that.
California.
What's that?
Well, California is a feeling when you eat the last bite of something delicious and then you become sad because you can no longer eat it.
How do you spell that?
He's lying.
You're such a tattletale.
Yeah, you'd get shanked in prison, Todd.
Oh, imagine all the fun things you'd get to try if you were someone's bitch.
Hey, Todd, remember when you were gonna learn how to eat me out?
I wish there was a word to describe how I'm feeling now.
You guys ready?
Ready.
Split.
Strong.